April 2011 has set a record for the most number of tornadoes ever observed in a calendar month in the United States. In particular, we had one really large event, April 27th, in which over 250 people have been killed, and we've had a large number of tornadoes in the southeastern United States.
The Storm Prediction Center, we issued outlooks for a major severe weather event as early as Sunday, which was 5 days in advance of the major tornado outbreak. We heightened the awareness and our threat level 3 days in advance, which is a very rare thing to go to our second highest level so early. And then we went to high risk, which is our highest alert level for tornadoes, for forecast tornadoes, the night before the tornado outbreak. We followed up that with 20 tornado watches, many of them particularly dangerous situations, which is our highest level of tornado watch. And the vast majority of tornadoes in this case occurred within particularly dangerous tornado watches. Critical within the Weather Service and NOAA is the local forecast offices. And the Storm Prediction Center works in partnership with them as we approach the event. And then as the event unfolds locally, these local forecast offices provide vital services to each of their customers in their local area. They provide all of the warnings, they're monitoring the radars, and after the event, they're going to provide the core information, survey each of the tornadoes, and measure how large this event was. Beyond NOAA, we rely very much on our partners in emergency management, in the media, and in the private sector to help us get the word out and make this information have an impact for the people on the ground.
For the month of April, we're estimating that approximately 600 tornadoes have occurred during this calendar month, which is the most we've ever seen in a single month.
Now, large tornadoes like this are very rare, and on this day they were all too common. And these are very strong, violent tornadoes. You need to be in a sturdy structure. You need to move away from mobile homes and weaker housing into very robust buildings, and then you want to get to interior areas of that building, away from windows, small space, interior, and if possible, you want to get below ground under something sturdy in order to withstand a direct hit from a tornado of these intensities.
Recent research has suggested that a La Nina pattern in the Pacific is favorable for the production of tornadoes. Now, this doesn't mean it's a guarantee you're going to get lots of tornadoes, but the La Nina sort of, you know, weights the coin a little bit into the side of for more tornadoes, and in particular, having those tornadoes occur in outbreaks. Some of our biggest outbreaks historically, the April 3rd and 4th outbreak of 1974 and the Palm Sunday outbreak of 1965, both occurred during La Nina years. As far as we can tell from the records that we have, which aren't perfect, there's been no change in the intensity or the frequency of tornadoes in the United States on the long time scale. From a physical perspective, our expectations of what will happen as the planet continues to warm isn't really very clear for tornadoes. Some of the ingredients that are favorable for tornadoes will become more frequent and more intense, but then some of the other ingredients that are favorable for tornadoes will become less frequent and less intense. And how that balance works out in the end is something we really can't tell yet.
Every day, there's people throughout the United States, particularly within NOAA and the National Weather Service, that are monitoring weather conditions, both in the future and in the current time, trying to make sure that people are forewarned when severe weather events like this unfold.